Cleveland, Miami, and Chicago. Of course, the Miami game will be in South Florida. Arenas is fouled with 3.8 seconds to play, so Gilbert will go back to the line where he's 7 of 11 tonight. What a job Eddie Jordan has done molding this team along, of course, with Ernie Grunfeld and the assistant coaches, and Milt Newton, Tommy Shepard. Third year in a row that the Wizards are headed to the playoffs. It's been some exciting basketball, most of it due to this guy. Gilbert is 8 of 12 from the free throw line, 29 points, 3 rebounds, 7 assists.
Making sure Michael Ruffin's going to match up with Chris Bosh.
Got it. No timeouts for Toronto. They go the length of the court. Ruffin tips it away. And no! Not possible! Not possible! Oh no! How did that happen?
Seemed like a long 3 seconds to me, but I was blocked by Eddie right in front of me.
Michael Ruffin tipped the ball up into the air, hoping that time would expire.
Wow, look at that shot from Peterson.
And he's lucky he wasn't fouled.
Unbelievable.
Morris Peterson, who has played 1 minute in this game, has just hit the shot to tie it.
Look at the stunned players out there. I mean, I'm sure it takes a minute for them to understand.
It's interesting because Bosh reached out and grabbed Michael Ruffin, but they elected not to call it. And now Peterson gets that shot off.
Unbelievable. You leave nothing to chance in this game.
Very close to contact there as Peterson throws it up, and Mo Pete hits his 101st three-point shot on the season.
Steve, this is the most difficult and challenging thing to do when you feel and see that you have a win, or think that that's the case, and to have a shot like that send in overtime, to get back into the huddle, regroup, and come out with some intensity to play this last 5 minutes. Was Ruffin trying to throw the ball, or was he losing control? I couldn't really.
Well, you know, maybe he didn't quite know the time. Again, I think Bosh reached out and grabbed Michael Ruffin, which may have caused him to not be able to control the basketball. I wouldn't mind seeing that again. See if Bosh tries to grab a hold of Ruffin.
He has it there. Yeah, he's getting ready to throw it. Maybe he just feels like the time has expired. He's just going to throw it down to the other end. But boy, and look at Ruffin grabbing his head, and all five players out there for the Wizards just stunned.
Keep in mind that TJ Ford has fouled out of tonight's game, so he will not play in the extra session. Meantime, Morris Peterson checked in with 9.3 seconds left in this game, and he hits the shot that's heard round Chinatown to tie the game at 109, and now the Wizards will have to play an extra session.
Well, here the long pass to Bosh, and Ruffin actually intercepts it, but again, yeah, like we said, he's going to throw the ball, and Mo Pete does the only thing he can do, heave it towards the basket, and it goes in.
Let's check in with Dave Branch.
Well, Steve and Phil, you guys were exactly right. The Wizards players were pretty stunned there on the side. And Eddie's biggest job in this timeout is to get their heads back in the game. He said, come on, come on. Stay alive, stay alive, stay alive. Let's get ready to play. And they're definitely going to have to stay alive in order to stay alive, don't you think?
Well, the Wizards are 3-1 in overtime this season. Well, it looked like they had this one in the bag. Now they're going to have to really, as you say, ratchet up the intensity here in the overtime period.